9:30, Wednesday, July 24th, 2024. We call this meeting to order. Start with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, old business, consideration of the minutes. Would entertain a motion.
I'll motion to approve the minutes for the session dated July 15th through July 19th.
Okay, I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, moving on to new business. Beer, wine, and liquor. Do we have any, Heather?
No.
I have it, it says note on here, so I didn't know what that meant.
Oh, for the payables.
Shoshone County payables, no, Justice Fund only. Okay, so we've seen the payables. Any questions or comments?
No.
No.
Okay. No homeowners cancellations this week or cancellations. First Interstate Bank renewal. Has everybody had a chance to look at that?
Yes.
Yeah.
Any comments or questions?
No.
It's just the sheriff's lease that's renewing on one of the vehicles.
Yep.
And we just need to sign the renewal for the bank.
Okay. We have resolution 2024-25 authorizing transfer of funds from the ambulance service district account to treasurer's accounts for the warrants issued between June 1st and June 30th of 2024. Any comment or question on those?
No.
Nope.
Okay. We have the resolution 2024-26 to establish mileage allowance for Shoshone County employees. Any comment or question on that?
No.
Nope. And I let Heather know every year I check the current rates.
So all we're doing is staying up with the current federal rate, which is what now, 67 cents?
Yeah.
Okay. Resolution 2024-27, authorizing the transfer of funds from the ILED account to the treasurer's account for expenses between June 1st and June 30th of 2024. Any comment or question?
No.
No.
Okay. Shoshone County Treasurer's Statement of Cash Balances as of June 30th. Any comment or question?
No.
Nope.
All right. In that case, I would entertain a motion to approve the consent agenda as read.
So moved.
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. So we have passed the consent agenda. We move to public comment.
Me?
Well, I go left to right, but I'm coming to Lori so she can think about if she wants to comment.
So I didn't have a comment on the audit last week. There's a lot of statements that are made in here that I don't believe are true. As if you've looked at the audit, the road fund was $267,120 over budget. The ambulance district was $103,862. According to the audit, the budget may be amended after a public hearing is held. Well, there was no public hearing held on either one of those two budgets to put cash in the reserves into the fund to cover the amount they're over expending. Ambulance district provides services wholly within the boundaries of Shoshone County. That's not true either. You know, we go to as far as top of 4th of July and into Matamon constantly. Your dings on your audit. For the procurement procedures, Tony only caught you on the coolers, I believe, or chillers, whatever it was. And if you remember right, the sanding trucks were about between $350,000 and $400,000. They never got bid. That's another one that wasn't bid. The generators for the county shops were never bid. That was $70,000, $80,000. There's a bunch that was never caught. The excuse is that the county was not aware of any formal procurement method requirements for federal awards.
For the record on those, what's the date of those purchases you're talking about?
2023 is when you guys came in and the Sandy trucks was in the spring, I believe, of 2023 when they were purchased. I believe the generators were done in May of 2023. So it would have been the 22-23 budget. What was off?
22-23.
Anyway, didn't know there was any procurement procedures. The procurement procedure in Shoshone County was passed June 2nd, 2021. It's all part of the federal procurement procedures. I don't think we've had a lot of turnover in the elected officials since this has been passed, or department heads to claim that they didn't know. Either they didn't read it, which is incompetent, or they didn't care. Don't know. That also might explain why this one is year-end financial closing reports. I'll give you a rough number. They didn't have any procedures on how to do it, anything else. In February of 2024, I did a public records request for a budget, the roads department's budget. By February, everything should have been put back on 21-22 budget year, and 22-23. They were $174,000 over budget in February. Like I said, everything should have already been put back by the middle of November. How do you end up $264,000 over budget? After February, you paid more bills. That's how messed up the financials are. Last thing I want to address is the financial meeting or the audit meeting. There's a lot of people in here that I don't believe that's between the commissioners, the auditor, and the clerk. Having all those people in here was ridiculous. We're paying for every one of them that were sitting in here. They can watch it online. And you had a 70-year-old man that didn't have room to sit and sat here on the floor. When you guys did the pay wage freeze, you moved it right upstairs because there wasn't enough room, and I believe it was all staff that came to that meeting. But you got a 70-year-old man that sits on the floor here. With all these guys that have no business being here, in my opinion, since it's between the auditor and you guys. Thank you.
Okay, any comments or responses or answers?
I think of any of the news press now.
What was that?
Do you have any comments?
No, I don't. Thank you.
All right. Executive session. We don't have anything, do we, today?
That's correct. Okay. We do not.
All right. So with that, we are adjourned.
Okay. Thank you.